What's up racers, Risa Beast here and welcome to another CSR2 video. Now this is a fourth video in the series where we try to take on these initial bosses. Today we are going to try and take on the tier 4 boss. His name is Victor. Okay, so before we even get on with this thesis, let's have a look at the car we'll be using. I will be using a 2015 Nissan GTR R35 Premium, and apparently this is one of the recommended cars for beginners, and in my opinion you should really get this one if you are just starting out on this game, because this is even good for live racing if you are just starting out. Okay, unfortunately this doesn't use the Elite system, so it has no stars, so you will have to get some more tier 4 cars if you from the rare imports if you want to have cars with gold or purple stars on them. But for beating Victor, this one is enough. Okay, so this one has 35 out of 42 upgrades. It has just one fusion part. Okay, and the tuning for this car is nitrous all the way to the right, final drive on 4.48 and transmission all the way down. Okay, this gives me a time of 13.758, which is enough to beat Victor. I mean, he runs a 14, so we are good there. We are good there, guys. Okay, let's just see if we can slightly improve this. 5.7. No. 5.3. 5.73. 5.79. Okay, I guess this is it, guys. 5.79 is the final one for this. This gives me a dyno of 13.7 on a half mile, which is good, which is great for beating Victor. He runs slower. Okay, so with that being said, let's get on with the races and let's see what we have here. Apparently KJ has returned. If you guys remember, we had beat him in the tier 1 battles where he was the boss, but he is there for a rematch, so this is interesting. This whole event has been organized by Tyler Shack, so I guess Victor Kid is working for him. Yeah, let's get on with the first race. Okay, those were some bad shifts, but let's see what we ran. Okay, if it's still below 14, we are beating Victor Kid easily. That was 13.9. it was close, but that's because we shifted, we didn't shift really well in that, so let's try to do better next race. Let's hit the next race. Her name is Ashley. Okay, even she was, we had raced her before as well. I mean, she is the tier 2 boss, the original tier 2 boss, so we'll be beating her second time. Now this car shifts very quickly. I mean, that is the only problem which I see with this car. Oh, and I'm so stupid, I forgot to hit the nitrous. The only problem that I see with this car, as I was saying, is this car shifts very quickly, and it might be a little bit hard to, you know, do the shifts one after the other, but that is the only drawback. I mean, apart from that, this car is great. Let's go with the third race. Donna's F50. Now this lady here, her name is Donna, and she's a mean woman. She will mess you up when it comes to winning cars from rare imports, so don't trust her at all. But apparently her F50 F50 is really good. I mean, you'll have a chance to win a F50 in one of the future races, okay? So, there is one issue with this Nissan. I mean, it accelerates quite decently at initial, you know, stages, but then later on it just stays on the same speed. I mean, its top speed doesn't increase in the later part of the race, okay? So it's really not a top speed oriented car, but I mean, hey, we just want to beat Victor, that's it. So it's good for beating Victor. His name is Tanin and he looks kind of weird. I don't know, I just think he looks weird. Let me know what you guys think about this guy. Why am I getting those early shits? And oh, I didn't even hit nitrous. Oh man. I really shouldn't be messing up these races. I mean, I have heard that all these characters, they have been taken from real life. So Daniel Leung, sorry if I don't recognize him, but he is one of the celebrities, and they really did a bad job, you know, making him look in the game like this. I mean, he probably looks very good in real life, but his avatar in the game, honestly, a little bit disappointing. So, let's get on with racing Victor here. Welcome to the final, introducing the fastest racer in town. I mean, if you call him the fastest, you must be joking, right? I mean, I am beating his crew members left and right, and I am going to beat him as well, so. Why do I always forget to hit the nitrous? I don't get it. I mean, maybe this car shifts so fast that I'm focused on shifting it and I forget to hit the nitrous, but I really need to pay more attention. But we are still running a 13.8, which is anyways better than his time, his final time what he will run. So I guess we are still safe. And apparently, after beating him a couple of times, you will see this. This is Tempest. And these are one of the bad guys in the game. You will face them later, okay? Not at the initial stages. Let's race him for the second time. So let's do a perfect shift there. I mean, even if this car's top speed is not that great, it still keeps pulling away from Victor's Jaguar, which just goes on to show that how bad of a car that Jaguar is. I mean, but this Nissan, I mean, even with not a great top speed, this car still does well in live, okay, because it accelerates very quickly at the initial stages, so that's great. So it's good to have this car as a beginner. Yeah, let's go for the final race. I mean, this is not the final race. There is one more race after this. But this is the race where we finally beat him and then he move on to claim his Jaguar. Okay. Speaking about... sorry for that. Speaking about that Jaguar, I mean, that car is okay. I mean, not even okay. I mean, I shouldn't be lying to you here. That car is really not that great. Okay. It's a boss car, and apparently this boss cars, they should be good, but they are not good. With a few exceptions, but this is not one of them. This is one of the slowest cars in tier 4, and I think the slowest Jaguar in the game. I couldn't put it in another way, but yeah. Tyler Shax, he is the final boss who we need to face. I mean, not the final boss. Sure, there is the Tempest storyline after we beat Shax, but he's one of the initial final bosses, okay? Initial final, that doesn't make sense, but he's the final boss of the first storyline. So now we are going to move ahead and claim Victor's Jaguar. Okay. We don't need Super Nitrous, guys. Trust me on this. We are going to beat him without Super Nitrous, without any stage 6 and without fusions. With just stage 5 upgrades, we are going to get and beat Victor and get his Jaguar. Okay. Let's go. And apparently I didn't shift that well, but no worries there, as we are way ahead. And yeah, we beat Victor and we are claiming his Jaguar. So there he ran a 14.1 and we ran a 13.7, so a 13.8, so we were way faster than him. Okay. Shax won't like this one bit. You better look after that car. Well, this is going to trigger Shax a little bit, but we don't care. And we apparently win this Jaguar. Well, I'm not feeling happy. Well, I mean, this is a collector's item, but it's really not that great of a car, as I said before. And honestly, it's okay looking. I mean, it's not that great. I mean, honestly, I like this Rocket Bunny's looks better than that Jaguar's. So maybe it's just me. Let me know what you guys think. Even that this Mustang looks dope. Okay. So guys, this is it for the video. In the next video, we are gonna try and take on Shax and claim his Koenigsegg, if that's how you spell it or pronounce it, but. We are going to win as Algera. Okay, so this is Reesabi signing off. See you in another video.